Then we saw Anthony Hamilton, who I think is an amazing God-given talent of singing.
Sure.
But my daughter is taller than him. And my daughter is probably about 4'7", 4'8". I'm like, do you need a stool to get your trophy? But, man, when I said we had an amazing time in L.A. Live, man, we saw Ashanti. Ashanti was walking around like she was Janet Wannabe Jackson. But she was far removed from that. But, man, we had a great time. We saw so many of these celebrities come through. I think, you know, the whole table, I call the whole table that we were sitting on the bopper table, because we kept looking every minute on the minute, every minute on the minute.
I heard that. That's what's happening, man. It's 12:02. What you want to do? We'll listen to the biggest, baddest name in sports. We are the Big Boys Sports Show, where big boys love their toys and big boys love their sports. Now, let's try this one more game. Let's hold on. And we're definitely going to get Mr. Reggie Smith on this damn show. So y'all hold on, y'all. All right? Y'all, don't you go nowhere. We're going to get him on now. We're going to do what we say we going to
on that good cushion alcohol.
Mike Wilmer.
I got some damn I can call. I don't know what I would do without y'all. I'm a ball to the day I fall.
Ball. Long as my bitches love me.
Stop hating, look, don't you got that fire? And they so love me like Satan, man. Yeah, me and get about it, and all she eat is beer. She's on a strict diet, that's my baby. With no makeup, she a 10, and she the best with that hair. Even better than Corinne, she don't want money. She want the time we could spend. She said, cause so tell me you're that somebody, girl. I fuck who I want and fuck who I don't. Got that A1 credit at that filet mignon. She say I never wanna make you mad.
All right, family, we back at it once more again. 12:04, giving you more than what you bargained for. And we are the Big Boys Sports Show, where big boys love their toys and big boys love their sports. Oh, my goodness. No, say it ain't so. It happened again. We had Reggie Smith. And it just, well, I tell you what, we had him. He was there. We were talking to him. All righty. All righty. So. That is what it is. But I'll tell you what, we're going to chop up a little more smoke before we make our way down the highway. So, now, let me ask you this, 99. Who was the best-looking lady you saw last night, man?
Man, I'm going to say my wife, because she's standing right here beside me.
Oh, that's a good-looking you saw.
I'm
saying that.
I'm going to tell you, my wife, but on hindsight, she just left the room. Man, it was so many beautiful, normal people out there. I mean, you know, the normal people were looking better than the superstars. But Ari Parker and Ciara, even though Ciara was pregnant, she still looked amazing. Ari Parker, she was very, very.
Well, so Ciara, I'm gonna release this story. People don't know this, but you know, Ciara's pregnant, right? You do know that. Everybody knows that. Yeah, well, that's my baby.
Wow. Yeah, the baby. Well, how you do that to you, man, with a fly artificial inseminated
man, listen here, plant. Listen here, man. You better.
I'm going to pray the Lord. I'm going to pray him.
She might be one of his bed warmers.
Man, you better recognize, boy. You better recognize my boy, don't you? Man, listen here. I'm a Oklahoma Will Chamberlain back in the day, boy. Better recognize. Better recognize who you talking to.
Oklahoma Will Chamberlain, that's the first.
They used to call me Oklahoma Will back in the day, fella. Better recognize game in your face, that you, Kennedy.
Call Will Call.
Hey, oh my goodness,
crazy,
man.
You know what's so crazy? I saw Terrell Owens, man, and the dude looks so, he looks so defeated and beat up, man. You know what? You know how he used to be all out there in the limelight, talking big, talking loud, man. I think that dude last night, the night before, we saw him at the JW Marriott. I like he was trying to hide behind palm trees. You know, this dude was real defeated and beat up, man, you know. And I was just looking at him, you know, my nephew, he went over there and talked to him. And he said, oh, man, the dude just looked just rough. You know what I'm saying? He was fell from grace and he walking in the valley, man. So, man, hey, if you a praying man or a praying woman, if y'all listen, man, pray for that dude, man, because this dude, he in a hellified storm right now, y'all. So, you know, pray for that brother, man. But, you know, I've never seen so many homeless people in L.A. that got dogs. Everybody's walking a dog. You know?
Hey, man, back to sports.
Well, I tell you what, man, listen. We want to send some love out to my girl, Lovey. Now, Lovey is my co-host of the Sunrise 09 Morning Show. She has an extensive radio background in Cumulus Radio, One Clear Channel. And she's also the CEO, the founder of the HNIC of the Pink Tea Foundation, which basically helps young ladies to play golf in the inner city. I don't want to mess up and say the wrong thing. It helps young ladies in the inner city play golf to achieve scholarships. Now, because there are a lot of scholarships that are left on the table every year. And I'd like to get Lovey to call in. If I could just get her to call in real quick to chop up some Pink Tea Foundation, because you'll hear more about the Pink Tea Foundation as we go along. We'll be definitely doing some golf tournaments, some basketball tournaments, and the Pink Tea will be all up in that thing. So if I could have my sister Lovey just to check in real quick, I would greatly appreciate it before we exit stage left. And we're in the midst of Super Bowl, brother. It's Super Bowl week, man.
Bedlam. Now,
Bedlam tonight. That's right. Bedlam tonight. Bedlam's tonight. Now, Oak State is coming to Norman. I'm telling you right now, pencil it in. Boomer Sooner tonight. We win by 7.
Uh-oh. Oh.
We win by 7.
Cam Clark is going to go off tonight.
He's going off. Know. Cam has, I talked with Cam earlier. He got 32 written in his 32 slotted for tonight. He got 32 coming tonight.
He ought to have 32. He's left it on the table in the other two games, so he should go back and get it. So he should be good tonight for 30.
Watch your mouth. You watch your mouth, buddy. What about my thunder? KD, MVP, baby.
Okay, you know what, Chu?
I will
give it up to you about your Thunder. Guys, I have to give it up for the Thunder because they're definitely playing championship-caliber basketball. When you have a situation where you have Kevin out, you have Russell out, and you still perform at a high level like that, they showed me something in that Boston game. They really, really showed me something. I was really impressed. And Chu, I've got to give it up, man. I got to give it up for you, Chu. Come on, man. They still play good ball, though, man.
I'm going to say this, and I'm going to say it with the utmost humility, and I'm going to go on the record and say this. The best player in the NBA resides in Oklahoma, and is number 35, Kevin Durant. The best player in the NBA across the board. LeBron, your time is coming up. It was short-lived, but the man of the hour, the man of NBA basketball guidance is Kevin Durant.
Okay, well, I'll tell you what we're going to do, guys. I'll tell you what we're going to do. We're going to go right to the phones right now and speak with Lovey. Hey, sister, how are you today?
Hey, hello. How are you all doing?
All right.
Hey, what's up?
Well.
How you doing, Lovey?
We're doing well. We're doing well.
Hello,
thank you. All right. We're thank you for joining us today. I was telling the good gentleman about the Pink Tea Foundation. Please let everybody know who you are and what the Pink Tea Foundation is all about.
Well, I was listening in this afternoon, and I heard Carl say that he was Sierra's baby daddy. I said,
"Yes,
yeah,
I am."
Until that child support check shows up, and then he's gonna be like, "See what happened was that ain't really my dad. That ain't really my baby."
Yeah.
You know, I do appreciate you recognizing the Pink Tea Foundation today, Carl. Pink Tea Foundation introduces inner city girls to the game of golf between the ages of 8 and 18. And currently, we're in the Dallas Metroplex area. We'll be in Dallas as well as McKinney, Texas, starting in as early as March, actually in a few weeks. And basically what happened, I started playing golf a few years ago when I lived in Atlanta, and I got hooked on it. And I found that there weren't a lot of minority women out there, so I figured, how can I give back to the organization or give back to the game of golf and these young girls? And basically, it's get them out on the course at an early age. So we started our program last year in Dallas, and we had touched over about 40 girls. So we're gearing up for our second year. It looks like we may have an opportunity to partner with the LPGA this year with their girls golf program. So that's going to be an exciting opportunity as well.
Wow. I have a question. When you're targeting, you say you're in Dallas, what areas are you in, you know, that are helping the girls out? And what areas in Dallas?
We're in the North Oak Cliff area, which is right off of downtown area at Cedar Crest Golf Course, as well as on the north side in McKinney, Texas, at Ocala Golf Course.
And you know what? I love how you made Oak Cliff sound so what is really not. You got your... I'm from that area. and congratulations. Bravo. I applaud you, because I thought you were going to probably say Plano or Richardson or somewhere. But, you know, you were really getting into the who and where it really matters. Where a lot of those kids don't have the avenues, nor do they have the resources to come out there and do that. So, you know, my hat is off. Because, like I said, I grew up right around the corner from the golf course area, you know, right off by Atlas and Ewing. So, you know, I truly know, but my hat is off. Thank you for coming back to our community, my community, and helping better some of these young women. Thank you very much.
Well, thank you. Definitely. That's really the goal and the purpose, is to get back into our community, introduce them to the game, and let them know that there are opportunities out there outside of, you know, the traditional sports like basketball and track. I know in 2009, the NAACP reported that 200 women's golf scholarships went unused.
Wow.
Basically because
we
just don't know about them, or, you know, we're not playing the game.
That is right. That is absolutely phenomenal. When you that statistic right there, Lovey, is what really sparked my interest in this movement. That statistic alone, when I saw that, I was just stunned. You're kidding me.
That's 200. Division one. That's division one, division two, JUCO. Even I know here in Dallas, there are some community colleges that have golf scholarships that could be available.
That's a great organization, and we're definitely looking forward to Pink Tea coming to the 405, the 918, and the 580 as well. We need some of that up in the Oklahoma area as well.
Yeah, they can find us online at www.pinktee.com.
All right.
We're always accepting donations, of course.
Yes. Donations are definitely in need.
Vital in order to the program's success.
Absolutely. Well, sister, we thank you so very much, and we're looking very much forward to you joining us again next Monday on
Sunrise
Online Morning Show. And we hope that you have a great week. Thank you for all that you do for the Pink Tea Foundation. All right, sister, thank you. Have a good
day. Thanks, guys. You have a great day.
All righty. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Lovey. All right, guys. Well, it's 12:15, and we're about to hit the door. So, all right, we're going to be on Friday. We're going to try to get this thing worked out in reference to Reggie Smith, and we're going to have Antonio Perkins on as well this coming Friday, and hopefully we'll actually get a chance to talk to him. You know we don't do that, guys. When we have somebody on the show, we actually have him there. We had some kind of discrepancy, but we'll get it worked out. We apologize for that, but we will definitely bring Reggie to the show, so you're going to have an opportunity to hear some conversation from that. Reggie Smith, that was Chu Kennedy. His views expressed on this show are not of that of the Big Boy Sports Show ownership or Kaleidoscope Radio Network or its affiliates.
It's
Chu Kennedy of himself in his own version. Chu Kennedy, ladies and gentlemen. All right, y'all. All right, well, I'll tell you what. Before we go to 99, let him close us out like we always do, we're going to go to my man 50 Grand, Mr. Kenny Smith. Kenny, what you got last words for the family, my brother?
Well, I want to tell the brothers that this week, Wednesday, the Thunder plays Miami in Miami.